Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to talk about DHCP, or Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Now, every computer or device on a network has to have an IP address for communication purposes. An IP address is an identifier for a computer or device on a network. And there are two ways that a computer can be assigned an IP address. It could be done by using a static IP or a dynamic IP. Now, a static IP is where a user assigns a computer or device with an IP address manually. Now, this was the original method that was done in the beginning of networking. So for each computer on a network, you had to open up the computer's network configuration page and manually type in an IP address. But in addition to an IP address, you also had to type in a subnet mask, default gateway, and a DNS server. And anytime that you wanted to add another computer or device to the network, you had to do the same thing. So as you might have guessed, this could be a lot of work, especially if you were dealing with a large network that has a lot of computers. And you also had to make sure that all the IP addresses are unique, because if you assign the same IP address twice, it would cause an IP conflict and would cause those computers to not have access to the network. But there is a better and easier way to assign a computer an IP address, and this is called a dynamic IP. A dynamic IP is where a computer gets an IP address automatically from a DHCP server. A DHCP server automatically assigns a computer with an IP address. And in addition to an IP address, it can also assign a subnet mask, default gateway, and a DNS server. So as an example, here we have the network connection properties window open for the network interface card on a Microsoft Windows computer. And as you can see here, this computer is set to obtain an IP address automatically. So when you choose this option, the computer would broadcast a request for an IP address on the network. Then the DHCP server will assign an IP address from its pool and deliver it to the computer. And then once that's done, you can verify all the different settings that the DHCP server has given your computer. And you can do this by opening up a command prompt on a Windows computer and then type in ipconfig:// all and then press enter. So as you can see here, the DHCP is enabled on this computer, which means that it's getting its IP address from a DHCP server. And then you can see the IP address here, along with the subnet mask, default gateway, and DNS server. So all of these settings were given by the DHCP server. So as you can tell, dynamic IP addressing is the best choice, because it's automatic and it makes managing a network a lot easier. Now, a DHCP server assigns IP addresses to computers on a network from its scope. And a scope is a range of IP addresses that a DHCP server can hand out. So as an example here, we see a scope of IP addresses on this server. So as you can see, the range starts with this IP address and ends with this IP address. So computers on this network will get an IP address from this range of IP addresses. So this scope can give out 100 IP addresses. Now these values can be customized to either increasing or decreasing the range. It all depends on what the network administrator wants to do. So it is customizable. Now when computers obtain an IP address from a DHCP server, the server assigns the IP address as a lease. So the computer doesn't actually own the IP address. It's actually a lease. And a lease is the amount of time an IP address is assigned to a computer. For example, the lease could be for 1 day. Now, the reason for the lease is to help make sure that the DHCP server does not run out of IP addresses in its scope. So as a demonstration, let's just say that this DHCP scope only has a range of 3 IP addresses. So it can only give out 3 IP addresses. Now, obviously, this is not very realistic because no network administrator is going to create a scope this small. But for this demonstration, let's just use this as an example. So let's go ahead and add 3 computers to this network. And as they are added, the DHCP server is going to assign them an IP address. So in this example, let's just say that the IP addresses are actually given to the computers and are not leased. So the DHCP has reached its limit on giving out IP addresses. All of its IP addresses are currently being used. But what happens if one of these computers is removed from the network? So if a computer is removed, it takes the IP address that it has been given with it. So let's say another computer gets added to the network, but the problem is the computer won't be able to access the network because the DHCP server has run out of IP addresses. So even though this computer here has been removed, it's still occupying an IP address that could be used for another computer. So this is why IP addresses are leased and are not given. Because if the IP addresses are leased, then this will tell the DHCP server which IP addresses are still being used and which ones are not being used. So in this example, the IP addresses are leased. So after a certain period of time during the lease, the computers will send a signal to the DHCP server asking the server to renew its lease of the IP address. So, in other words, it's informing the DHCP server that it's still present on the network and its IP address is still being used. So, if a computer is removed from the network, that computer is not going to be able to ask the DHCP server for a renewal. And if it doesn't ask for a renewal, then the lease will expire and then the IP address will go back to the IP address pool. So now the IP address can be used for another computer. And this is why IP addresses are leased. Now, if you wanted a computer or device on your network to have a specific IP address all the time, in other words, you never want that IP address to change, well, you can create a reservation on the DHCP server. A reservation ensures that a specific computer or device identified by its MAC address will always be given the same IP address when that computer or device requests an IP address from the DHCP server. So, for example, on this DHCP server, if I create a reservation for my computer, the DHCP server will recognize my MAC address and will always give me this specific IP address. Now, reservations are not typically given to regular computers. They are typically given to special devices or computers such as network printers, servers, routers, etc. because devices like these should be given the same IP address constantly. Now, one final thing to note about DHCP is that DHCP is a service that runs on a server. For example, this could be a Microsoft server or a Linux server. But it's also a service that runs on many routers also, whether the router is a business router or a small office, home office router. These routers will have a DHCP service built into them.